In this video, I am going to explain by example, firstly, how password sharing between multiple houses used to work, how it works now, and finally then demonstrating how it can be bypassed. I have found that if you can picture the old situation, the changes Netflix has made, and how a bypass of the resultant restriction can be made, your understanding of the problem and any pros and cons of any bypass solution will be greatly enhanced. The reason I made this video is because this issue happened to me, and when I looked around, I could find only broad brush information on how I could resolve it, which resulted in a lot of unnecessary trial and error on my part until I got it right. So, this video, after explaining the latest Netflix changes, it then demonstrates the detailed steps I eventually used to bypass it, so hopefully you will find it more straightforward than I did to implement. So, without further delay, after this short introduction, I'll get cracking. To explain this more easily, I am going to use this character called Steve, but the reason I am making this video now is I too have just faced this problem. Now Steve has his main house where he spends 10 months or so of the year, and a holiday home which he rents for a couple of summer months. Now at both these separate locations, he, as the Netflix account holder, wants to be able to watch his Netflix shows. He just used to be able to do it, but following their recent changes is now presented with an error screen when he tries to log into Netflix from his summer holiday home location, saying he does not appear to be signing in from his household IP address, so they block him. He is therefore trying to think of a solution to this problem, so he is able to still watch Netflix when on holiday. So on the next page, I will show you how he did it. Now let me just say before I start the video proper that I do not condone circumventing Netflix terms and conditions, and they are perfectly within their rights to do this. However, there are some circumstances, like in this example, where there is a legitimate reason to access the one Netflix account from multiple locations. Now this is how it used to work. As I said earlier, Steve has two locations he needs to access Netflix from, his main house and his rented holiday home, which he uses for a couple of months in the summer. So if I firstly start by drawing in Steve's main house, where he watches Netflix on his TV and logs in with his account details. When he signs in to Netflix, it sends his login credentials to his router, which in turn sends them out over the internet. They emerge from the internet at the main Netflix servers. They firstly confirm his logon details are correct, and if everything is okay, returns pictures and videos to his TV. So, this is the summer house, where there also is a TV on which he watched Netflix. It too sent requests out to the Netflix servers, and they used to allow him to use his Netflix account to watch movies and TV programs from this second location. However, since the recent Netflix changes, all he now gets is an error message when logging on from this second location. This is because Netflix has started to use the router's IP address from each location, and only now allows logons from the main household IP address. As a slight mitigation, however, they have also started identifying individual devices, so if one ever tries to log in from a non-household IP address, they are allowed to log in, only if in the past 31 days, they have logged into Netflix from the main house, using the main house's IP. He doesn't want to try changing the IP that Netflix treats as the household IP to his summer holiday home, as there are family members back at the main house who still need to log on, and it is important to him that any bypass solution he uses in no way impacts their use. So the challenge he has is to make his summer house use of Netflix appear to come from his main household IP address, or at least do so once in every 31 days. His solution is to route his network traffic to his main house first, and from there to Netflix. He does this by using a PC product called Meshnet, which is made by NordVPN. Now, before you switch the video off, note that it is a completely free product they offer, and it in no way requires you to use the main NordVPN product. In fact, Steve here, doesn't he just uses their free Meshnet component? So what it needs, and I will be demonstrating all this in a minute, is a PC, be it Windows, Mac, or Linux, running in the main household, which has the Meshnet host component running on it. Then, on the summer house smart TV, from its app store, he needs to install the NordVPN app, from which we will only be using the free Meshnet component. Unfortunately, he understands that at the moment, only Android TVs have it in their app store, but the TV in the rented holiday house is not one of those. Nonetheless, just in case it has become available recently, he checks the TV's app store anyway. However, it also works on many devices that can just be plugged into the TV, like a Google Chromecast, a Roku, or even an Amazon Fire Stick. Steve has an Amazon Fire Stick, although if he didn't, it would cost about £35 to get a new basic one from Amazon. The advantage of using something like a Fire Stick, which just plugs into a TV, is once set up, he can take it with him wherever he goes, even to other countries, and continue to connect his Netflix account through his home IP address. So, on the Amazon Fire Stick, he will need to use both its Netflix and NordVPN applications, from which he will just use the Meshnet component, but now in client mode. This is because the Meshnet traffic redirection component is only able to redirect traffic emanating from the device it's on, so in this case, not from the TV itself, so he needs to run Netflix on the Fire Stick. His Fire Stick traffic, when Meshnet is switched on, will firstly be directed to his Meshnet host PC in his main house, before being sent to Netflix servers from there. It is just worth mentioning at this point in the video that if Steve had a tablet or phone, be it an Apple or Android-type device, and was happy watching Netflix on that, he can connect and watch from those, as those device types are not IP address restricted. This is because Netflix realizes that these device types can connect to lots of different mobile phone masts, and as a result come from a whole host of different IP addresses. Because of this, whether he was connected to his summer house Wi-Fi or a local mobile phone mast, he should be able to watch Netflix, as they don't bother trying to restrict these device types. However, if he does, he will just need to be careful of his mobile phone data usage if connecting through his mobile phone provider and not his Wi-Fi router. Okay, that's enough theory. Now I will demonstrate the practical side of actually doing it. I will take you through this in short, simple steps, so anyone should be able to do it. On the main house's PC, I briefly show you its external IP address it uses when on the internet, which ends in 180. So, as I showed you earlier on the diagram, this is the one that Netflix treats as the household IP. As a result, this is the PC on which we will be installing the Meshnet host component. Now I open a new tab, search for, then go to the official NordVPN website. This is because the free Meshnet component we want is contained within their main VPN client, which I therefore need to download and install. So once on their site, I download the main application. Once downloaded, I close any open windows and start the installation process, zooming in so it shows more clearly on this video. And that's it, the installation of the product is now complete. In the next part, I will show you how to get a free account. Now that it's installed, I start the main NordVPN product. When opened, I select the option to create a NordVPN account, which takes me to their webpage offering all their paid plans. But I don't want any of those. I want a free account instead. So, to obtain one of those, counterintuitively, I firstly select Login and then the Sign Up option on the resultant screen. This brings up the Create a Free Account page, which requests only my email address, which I confirm, followed by a password. And that's it, the free account has now been created. Now, having installed Meshnet and created an account, we are ready to turn it on. To do that, I start the product and then select the login button. That opens a web browser to the Nord account website, where it asks for first my user ID and second my password. Once my login details are confirmed, it asks if it can open the main Nord product, which I confirm. And then select the free Meshnet component. This screen just reminds us that Meshnet offers three distinct capabilities: that we can share files with another computer, we can route traffic through a remote computer, or they can route traffic through this PC, something we will be doing in a moment. Or it can provide access to remote devices like printers, scanners, network shares, etc. Actually, I plan to do that after making this video, to back up the whole video project to an off-site remote backup device on someone else's network some 300 miles from where I am sitting now. So, Meshnet can provide any combination of these three capabilities. I am happy to proceed, so I turn Meshnet on. On the resultant screen, there are a couple of areas that I would like to draw your attention to. Firstly, this computer has automatically been given a name within this account, which can be used to identify it in other Meshnet devices. And secondly, there are two types of devices that Meshnet support. Internal devices using this Nord account will automatically be granted permission to use all three Meshnet capabilities on this device. So the currently logged on user's Nord account details should only be given to a very limited number of individuals, as with them, they can get full access to this PC's home network. Full details of any connected devices, whether they be for another PC or, as in this case, a Firestick, will appear here if the Internal Devices tab is selected. And secondly, the External Devices tab, which shows remote devices running the Meshnet product using potentially another free Nord account, which you have invited to join your network or have already been accepted. When you invite someone else's device, you will be presented with this screen, on which you will enter the Nord account email address they used to sign up. And at the same time, you have the ability to restrict the permissions for this invite. Then, when they log in to their Nord account and start Meshnet on their device, they will see and can accept the invite. If I was doing this as part of the video, I would only allow any device using their Nord account to route traffic through this PC and not allow access to my network or any of the devices on it. However, for this video, I am just going to be using the one Nord account, the internal one, so I return to the main screen. And that's it, we now have the Meshnet host PC fully up and running. Okay, so now we are going to install the free Meshnet product and Netflix on the Firestick in the holiday home. So back on the Firestick, as you can see, I have already installed Netflix, and I will be installing NordVPN Meshnet product in exactly the same way. To do that, I go down to the search bar and look for the NordVPN product. Once installed, I return to the home screen, then move the newly installed app into the first five icons so it appears on it for the rest of this video. Finally, I return to the home screen. We now have everything we need, so in the next chapter, I will show you how I could bypass the Netflix password sharing restrictions. If I first show you the current situation and then what was involved in bypassing it. So on the Firestick, I start the default Amazon Silk Internet web browser. To save time, I have already pointed it to the TunnelBear website, as that shows on screen the IP address being used, and to prove it shows up-to-date information, I refresh it. As you can see, it is not yet using the main house IP address. That ends in 180. I return to the home screen and select the Netflix application. At the moment, it gives an error message telling me I am not using Netflix from the main house. The exact wording may be different in each country, but the meaning is similar. I now return to the home screen and start the NordVPN product so I can use their Meshnet component. There are many ways to sign in. I use one of them off-screen. I now scroll down and turn on Meshnet and select the route traffic option. Once selected, it summarizes all the devices it can connect to that offer that facility. I select the only one on this account, which is the one in the main house. After it's connected, I return to the home screen. To prove all internet traffic has been routed through the main house, I open the internet application and refresh the web page. All traffic is now emerging from the main house's router and has its IP address, which ends in 180. I return to the home screen and show Netflix now works. I have blurred out the screen here to stop any chance of a copyright strike for this video, but you get the gist. Again, I return to the main screen. Now, because I have signed into Netflix from the main house IP address, Netflix currently allows me to log into Netflix from any IP address for the next 30 days. If it tightens up these requirements further, I may also need to be coming from the household IP address for, say, an hour, or in the most extreme case, permanently. But for now, simply logging on is enough. So, as to not use the house router unnecessarily and its internet bandwidth, I disconnect. I then return to the home screen and, using the web browser, prove the IP address it's now using is the original one. Finally, I restart Netflix to prove it still works. And that's it. I'm now able to watch Netflix from the holiday home. If you have found this video either interesting or informative, please think about pressing the like button, as that seems to mean it gets shown to others via scoring well on the YouTube algorithm. Also, I would really appreciate feedback in the comments stating your country and whether this bypass worked for you. It will help others, especially if future Netflix restrictions are country-specific. Thanks. On screen, you can see the video that YouTube has selected especially for you based on your viewing history. And if you want to see more instructional videos like this one in the future, click on the CloudTech logo. Thanks for watching.